A good evening. Welcome to Moscow Kazanskaya. This is where the trains direction Kazakhstan, for example, leave from. We won't go all the way to Kazakhstan tonight. There will be another video going to Kazakhstan. We will do the first parts by a night train to Samara. This will be on a Fermany train, which means this is one of the higher ranked trains within the Russian train system. In general, Fermany trains do have a name as well. We will be traveling on the Zhiguli, when I pronounce it right, probably say completely wrong. I hope you enjoy the trip. A couple of days earlier, I arrived by streets in Moscow from Berlin. You can see this in my previous trip report, where there's also a small station review of Moscow Belaruskaya. The train I'm taking right now will be leaving from Moscow Kazanskaya. On the other part of the street from this station, you'll find two other major Moscow railway stations, Leningradsky railway station and Yaroslavsky railway station. These three major railway terminals share one metro stop called Komsomolskaya. The metro is the best way to travel within Moscow. They're fast, they run very frequently, and they're also the cheapest way to travel. Apart from that, the metro stations in Moscow are just great. They're like little railway cathedrals under the ground. Because I wanted to see all this awesomeness under the ground, I almost spent 3/4 of a day at the Moscow metro. I didn't take many videos, only the ones at the railway station, but I took lots of photos I still have to edit. In the metro station, it has been clearly marked what exit you have to take for what railway station, both in Russian and English. You can't miss this. I went for a quick visit to the other stations as well. Leningradsky station is the station where the trains to St. Petersburg leave from. Actually, these were the only trains on the screens. There were no other destinations at the moment I was here. This is also the only station where I found the announcement in Chinese. This is also where the Sapsan, the Russian high-speed train that runs between Moscow and St. Petersburg, leaves from. This is by far the most efficient way to travel between these cities. Yaroslavsky railway station is the station where the famous Trans-Siberian train leaves from. This is marked as train number 1 from Vladivostok to Moscow and train number 2 from Moscow to Vladivostok. It's also listed here on the screen. Well, I wanted to see it because it's a long time ambition of mine to take this train, but I didn't spend all day to wait for this train. Back to Moscow Kazanskaya, where my train is leaving from. Maybe I just didn't look good at the other stations, but to me it felt like this is the biggest station of the three stations I just show you. The second floor, there's a big waiting area, there's even a playground, and you find lots of lockers to drop your luggage. When I arrived in the evening, the waiting areas were pretty busy, and the one upstairs was the, well, less busiest one. The station itself has lots of shops to buy some stuff you may need for your journey, like some food or drinks or whatever. But in the train you can buy lots of goods as well, at least in my train. On the next train, that was not the case, and the next train I'm taking is doing the same route as this train I'm doing right now. Digital departure and arrival screen, train announcements and also indicators at the station that say which way you have to go for where are all in both Russian and English. I think other countries like the Netherlands, where I'm from, could take an example of this. Keep in mind that when you have to enter a Russian railway station, your luggage have to go through an X-ray scan. Apart from long-distance trains, this station is also being served by lots of commuter trains. The route between Moscow and Samara is being run by several trains per day. Although I never heard of Samara before I went on this trip, it's a big city with a population of over 1 million people. Travel by train in Russia and many other former Soviet countries is not expensive. Well, it's as expensive as you like to make it. For example, the train on the left is a double-deck train that runs between Moscow and Samara. It's in general a little bit cheaper than my train. For the route Moscow-Samara, I checked several trains and prices. The prices vary between 1,000 ruble, what is absolutely the lowest price, and 15,000 ruble. So from about 14 euro between 211 euro. This is my train from Moscow to Samara. I booked on a 4-berth sleeping compartment, also called second class. The category I booked is a little bit more luxury, there was some food included as well. This is not standard when you travel on these types of trains. At the end of each bed there's a reading light and there's lots of space for your luggage. You can take a lot of stuff with you. There's a big mirror at the door and there is even a TV in the compartment. Basic route information is shown at the end of each carriage. Free Wi-Fi is available, and when you want to call the conductor, there's a button above the non-smoking sign you can press, well, to call the conductor. They sell goods as well in this train. I'll get back to this later. The beds were already made, and there's lots of space for the luggage under the lower beds and at the compartment above the door. But in this train I probably should say the compartment behind the TV. Just like in my previous train, you get a free pair of slippers and some toiletries. You can climb the upper beds by using the ladder that will come off like this. A power plug can be found under the table. Like I mentioned earlier, there's lots of space for your luggage, but there's even extra space over here. There's a towel included as well. When you stay at the upper beds, there's also lots of space for your luggage, like in the lower beds I just showed you. You can see it here. There's also a towel included. At the end of the carriage, you'll find two toilets. The toilets were kept very clean during the ride, although it wasn't a long ride. Food and even souvenirs can be bought at the conductor. It's displayed like this, so even people who don't speak any Russian can just point to what they want, really easy. At the end of each carriage, there's also a display that indicates what kind of snacks there are. And of course, you also find a samovar at the end of each carriage to tap hot water for tea or noodles. In this train you also find a dining car. Well, I love dining cars, but I didn't went there for some food or a drink. I had dinner before, the train is leaving around 8, and when you want something to drink or some snacks, you can also get it in your carriage, and that's actually a little bit easier, although I still love the romance of dining cars. When you close the curtains like this, you're not disturbed by any light during the night. In the morning I took the food that was included in my ticket, had lots of tea that will only cost you 5 ruble, and I just sit back and let the landscape pass by. In the morning the skyline of Samara pops up, and not long after that the train is crossing the Samara River. The train is perfectly on time and I still have all day to discover the city. This is why I love night trains. They're not fast, but they're very efficient when it comes to costs. You save a hotel and time because you sleep and travel at the same time.
So, good morning from Samara. It was a smooth ride from Moscow to Samara. I slept pretty well, to be honest. I didn't expect that. I knew I had some kind of extra second class, but there was a good breakfast included. There was even some, well, food already when I came into the cabin. I don't know how to give through that you're a vegetarian. I mean, I'm a flexitarian, so I try not to eat meat. But when I have it, and especially when I'm traveling, I eat meat. Do a station review about the Samara when I take my next trip, which will be departing from Samara. I hope you like this video. Please give me a thumbs up when you like this video, and subscribe to my channel when you like to see more of these videos. Goodbye for now.